Welcome to Geopolitical Horizon. Today I want to share a few reflections on the future of European-US relations in a long-term perspective. But first, let's take a brief look backwards and also let's take a look at the current situation. So during President Trump's administration, we really saw European-US relations sliding apart. Now, with President Biden in the White House in the US, there were many that had high hopes that European-US relations would again come back to normal state and we could really see European-US relations flourish in a positive direction. However, with the recent Biden decision to withdraw the remaining 2,500 US troops in Afghanistan, that really has shown the cracks in the European-US relationship. There were disagreements between Europe and the US decision to withdraw. In European capitals, there were many that felt that the US made a unilateral decision when in fact the entire Afghanistan operation started with an Article 5 decision within NATO, where European troops went to Afghanistan to support a US-initiated military mission. However, currently, we are seeing cracks within the military and security ranks between Europe and the US because of the recent fallout, the situation in Kabul, particularly at Kabul International Airport. And we're just gonna see, I think, more of that going forward. Now, there are a range of areas that we need to consider when looking forward into the future. But I think that the long-term trajectory in European-US relations are gonna show signs of sliding apart. So first of all, commercial relations. You know, the Biden administration maintains the tariffs imposed on the EU, the steel tariffs 25%, aluminium tariffs 10%, that President Trump's administration imposed, that has been kept in place with the Biden administration. Now, there were many that hoped that Biden would kind of reverse that policy and other policies implemented by President Trump, but he hasn't. In fact, President Biden has also kept the tariffs towards China and many of the various facets of US-China policy that President Trump implemented have been kept by President Biden. Now, looking into the future, I think there are going to be various challenging moments in commercial relations between Europe and the US. These US tariffs that are now imposed may be withdrawn. We may see Biden change that policy going forward. However, in the future, with the US focusing now inwards, the $1 trillion US dollar infrastructure bill that was recently passed in the US Senate, that's going to focus on infrastructure investments in the US. And that is interesting. So, I mean, the US is really looking inwards. It's focusing very much on the US first policy that President Trump implemented. But President Biden is really keeping that and also continuing and strengthening a US first policy in many ways. So in terms of the political relationship between Europe and the US, I think we're also going to see they're sliding apart because of various reasons. Number one, Europe shares geography with China. Europe's relationship with China will strengthen over time, even though there are challenging moments right now politically. But China is the largest trade partner for Europe. And therefore, I think we're also going to see more infrastructure connections. We're going to see more supply chains from Europe to China. In addition, we're going to see more infrastructure connections towards the Middle East, towards Central Asia. And I think that's just going to be very, very important for Europe going forward. You know, the US does not share geography with China as Europe does. For example, also in terms of immigration, the migration we now may see from Afghanistan, the influx of refugees that is also continuing from Africa and from the Middle East and from Asia, that is something Europe needs to handle and deal with. And the various ways that are going to be done, but I think it's going to be important for Europe to invest heavily in the future in Central Asia, in Asia. And therefore, relations with China is also going to be very important. Therefore, I think there are various reasons why Europe and the US-China policies are going to differ more and more in the future. Currently, Europe's and the US-China policies are very much aligned. They have a very strong focus on containing China, on challenging China politically, but trade-wise, they want to strengthen relations, also in terms of business relationships. But I think that the long-term trajectory, again, to come back to that, with Europe and the US looking at European-US relations, I think we're going to see that slowly they will slide apart in a long-term perspective. That's not going to happen in the first coming years. We're probably going to see US-European relations and, you know, general visits, mutual calls, and, you know, summits and political conferences continuing on high levels regularly, and European-US relations are going to be kind of maintained in the coming years more or less at the current level and state. However, looking, you know, 10, 15, 20, 25 years into the future, I think we may see European-US relations changing and sliding apart. Remains to be seen how far, but 25 years from now, remains to be seen whether or not we will have a NATO. I mean, during President Trump's administration, there were moments when I think a lot of people felt that NATO may fall apart. If President Trump wins an election in 2024, you know, he may decide to pull out. That remains to be seen. If another Republican were to win the presidency, he or she may decide to pull out, because I think that a lot of the policies that President Trump focused on and implemented will probably also be in focus with another Republican president. All the personalities will differ. However, again, taking a long-term look at the trajectory of future relations between US and Europe, I think they're going to be sliding apart. I think that is going to be an important thing to focus on also for large international companies, because I think that should be a part of the strategic forecast and the long-term strategic global planning. Now, it remains to be seen how that will take its shape, but there is, you know, increasing cracks already between various European capitals and the US. There are differing positions on a range of issues in terms of security, in terms of military relations. There are many countries now increasingly in Europe focusing on investing in military capacity. That's not only because they're a NATO member, but I think they realize that they need to strengthen their own internal security. For the long term, I think that's going to be important, because currently, most European countries have basically not focused enough on military buildup and defense spending. And that is a huge challenge, not only within NATO, but also for European countries themselves independently. So going forward, there are going to be a range of challenges, I think, in European-US relations, both in terms of military security aspects, but also politically, in addition to commercial aspects, but also on the larger global stage with China policy, Russia policy, Russia and Germany now completing the Nord Stream 2 pipeline. The US and Germany made an agreement. But still, there I think are going to be more cracks we're going to see in the future between European countries and the US. So for the long term, remains to be seen. However, I think that Europe and the US will slowly slide apart in various ways, which will affect European-US relations. Thank you so much for joining. Please remember to subscribe to Geopolitical Horizon. I look forward to see you again. Thank you.